Well, welcome back to another lab. After you read what we're going to do in this lab, you might be thinking to yourself, well, this is a lot like the first mini lab. You are correct. However, today we're going to do everything using PowerShell. In the first mini lab of this playlist, we use the portal. So let's go ahead and get started. I listed the types of resources, the names of the resources I'm going to use. SpeedRG is going to be my resource group. East US will be the region. Speed Storage will be the account name, or storage account name. Speed Share will be the share name inside the storage account. Speed Dir will be the folder inside the share. And then add is.psplumb will be the file inside the directory. All right, so first thing we want to do is create our resource group. So we'll define some variables here. Resource group name is equal to $ speed dash speed dash rg. Next we want the region. And for us, or at least for me, it's going to be East US, taking a break from East US 2. Now the command, new AZ resource group, give it a name, come on IntelliSense, there we go. $ resource group name and region. Location. And then $ region. REG. Okay, that should do it. Let's see. Name, resource group name. That looks right. Okay, now I thought I went perimeter name. The argument is nil or empty. Oh, you know what we didn't forget to do? Forgot to run these two commands. There we go. Now we're rolling. All right, let me re-log in here and it'll be rolling. Okay, so what all I did was I used the login AZ account and I gave my credentials and I'm logged into Azure now via PowerShell. So now let's try it for the third time. Oh, astounding, and we have success. All right, our next step is to create the storage account. So let's define some more variables. Storage account name equal to, and I'm going to use speed storage. And this needs to be what? What's unique about the storage account name in Azure? Not going to give you the answer now. That will be coming up. However, there is a little hint here. Oh, let's come back up here. Let me come back up here to line number 9, make a space, and just say here, create the storage account. All right. $ storage account is equal to new AZ storage account. Resource group name, $ resource group name. Name is going to be $ storage account name. Location, $ region. And SKU name, we'll do a standard ZRS. And kind, storage version 2. And did we leave anything off? Location, SKU name, let's see. Access tier, we don't really care about. I think we are good. All right, let's run this, get it in memory. Now I'll run the command to create the actual storage account. Go check to see how the portal looks, and I'm in my resource group. No resources. Let's try the refresh button, and there we go. We got our resource group created and our storage account, and notice it produced this random number for us. Because why? All storage groups need to be what? Oh, answer coming up in the test knowledge section. Okay, let's continue with the lab by creating the file share. All right. Ooh, we should probably move this line. I don't like to use line 13. I'm pretty superstitious. There we go. 14. All right, create the file share. And this share is going to go inside the storage group, of course. $ share name is equal to, I'm going to use speed share. AZ storage share. Got a typo there. Name, $ share name, and then context, then storage account, context. Okay, that should create our share for us now. Outstanding. Okay, so now we have a storage account and we have a share inside that storage account. Next, we need a directory inside our share. So create a directory, D-I-R-E, it's called directory, C-T, directory, or file, or folder, inside, share. All right, so new AZ storage directory. And we'll go with context. That'd be $ storage account. Context. Share name. $ share name. And then path, which will be speeder. There we go. Let's give that a shot. Outstanding. Let's go check out what we have in the portal so far. Minimize that. Okay, so here's our storage group. Inside here, we should see a share. And there's our share. Then inside here, we should see a folder, which is excellent. Our next step is to put a file inside the folder. Okay. So, $ create a file, or we should say upload a file to the file share. All right. Outstanding here.